Hello everyone, it's Carly and welcome back to my channel and welcome back to Vlogmas Day 4 and also welcome back to our December's empty video. I do empties videos twice a year. I do it in June and December, and every single time I do them, I never think that I'm gonna have enough or that I don't use any products or I never have anything, but I always surprise myself and these videos always tend to be a little bit rambly and long. So I'm gonna try to shorten it up for you guys. I have a lot of fun things here to chat about. I love these videos because they're not just like favorites videos, they also include things that I used up but like would never purchase again or don't recommend, things like that. And you guys also seem to like them as well. So if an empties video is new to you or you are new to my channel and you enjoy this video, please consider subscribing. It means a lot to me and it helps grow my community and grow my channel, and I really would appreciate it. Let's hop into the video. So I have two bags of products. Like I said, I'm gonna try to keep it short and sweet and just run through everything. I think I'll go into this Starbucks bag that is already not tied up. So the first thing I have is my Dr. Teal's foaming bath salts, and this is in the lavender flavor. I love this stuff. I repurchase this again and again. It's just a good like size, and it also just makes my bath feel really relaxed and bubbly, and the bubbles are so nice. So I always get this, and it's easy. It's at my grocery store, so I definitely repurchase that all the time. It's one of my favorites. I have this Tresemme hairspray, a little big thing of it. I like Tresemme. Also, I don't really use a ton of hairspray, and so when I buy it, it just like always is so astonishing that some hairsprays are like $15. Like, I don't understand that. So this is always like $5 and I really like it. And again, I don't really use a ton of hairspray. It's just not really my jam. So when I do use it, I just grab this one and it works fine. I have a Morphe continuous setting spray by Morphe. I love this stuff. It works so well to set your makeup. And the little spray is also so even, so fine. You don't get any like big clumps on your face. And it's also a great price point. Morphe's always good about that, so I really love it. Moving on to a skincare product. This is the PHA Moisture Renewal. I cannot read today. This is gonna be an effing hard video. Moisture Renewal Power Cream by Cosrx or CosRx. I literally never know. I love this stuff. I really, really love this brand. I've tried a bunch of stuff from them and it continues to be like one of my favorite brands to go for skincare. It's a Korean skincare brand and I just really enjoy it. I love the way it makes my skin feel. It makes it feel so supple and hydrated, never breaks me out, never irritates me. So if you haven't tried Cosrx, I will leave a link to them down below so you can check them out because I love it. It's just at Ulta or you can get it online. I have a Tree Hut Tahitian Vanilla Bean Sugar Scrub. I love these. I think my mom actually got me this one. And I love anything vanilla. I really, really do. I really love the Dove body polish over like a Tree Hut, but this stuff is still so good. It just doesn't make me feel as like moisturized as the Dove one does, which is interesting, but I do love this. I just love any kind of a sugar scrub. I have the L'Oreal True Match Lumi Foundation, which I did use this up, but I didn't repurchase because I just noticed that this makes my skin feel like it's slipping and sliding everywhere, and so this is definitely a no-go. I was using it and I thought I really loved it, and then I turned it on to my mom and I was like, you have to try this, and then she tried it and hated it, and then it made me realize that like, yeah, I don't like it, so moving on. Another foundation, I have the e.l.f. Flawless Finish Foundation. I used this one up. I did like it. I liked it because, well, I first got introduced to this from Adrienne Bylone. She like had this in one of her YouTube videos and I was like, oh, should I try it? And I like it. It's definitely not my favorite, but for a cheap foundation, it did do pretty well for me. I don't know about like shade range or anything like that. When I went, there was only three, so not the best, but I don't know if they've like upped it or anything. So not too much to say about this, but it did work well for me, but I probably won't pick it up. I have my trusty Dove spray deodorant. This is in the cool scent. I love this. This stuff is so heavy duty. It's absolutely insane. I bought this and then I went to a natural deodorant and I could only wear the natural deodorant for like 2 days and I miss this so much. I have one in my bathroom. I always have one with me. It's just great. It makes me feel so fresh and so clean all day long, especially when I work out or I'm at work all day. It's just a really good one. So I finally finished up the Lancome Absolute Powder. I love this stuff. My sister, there's kind of still a little bit in there, but I cannot get it out. So I just figured I'll just pop it in here. So I'm not using it anymore, but my sister did give this to me and I do really love it. It is Lancome, so I don't even know the price point for this, but I really love it. I really want to get my hands on the Jaclyn Hill one. I've heard that that one's a really good one because she really likes this one. So I feel like when she makes her own, it will be great. So I really want to try that. But for the meantime, I'm just using something else. But this is really good stuff. Moving on to another skincare product. This is a moisturizer. This was a rose water moisturizer by Mamed. I do not know how to say this. But it was really good. I don't really love the scent of rose water. I feel like it can kind of make me feel like my skin is getting irritated. I don't know why, but I used this and then at the same time I was using like a rose water toner. So I think having two of them at the same time was a little bit too much for my face, but it was a nice gel consistency. I used it in the summer. It made me feel so cool. So I really liked it. I don't know if I'll repurchase again. I like just kind of a creamier, thicker moisturizer personally for myself. So I don't know, but it was beautiful and it's a beautiful packaging and yeah. This is the Origins Ginseng Scrub Cleanser. I used this for a little bit and I did like it. I did finish it up, but it's definitely something that I'm not gonna repurchase just because I'm doing a more of a chemical exfoliant rather than like a physical one. So I'm gonna not pick this up again, but it did work really well. It did like wake me up in the morning. I do want to try their ginseng like eye cream if I am going to go back to like the Origins brand, but definitely like ditching the scrubs for my face. Okay, we're getting to the bottom of the first bag. I have a Boschia Makeup Breakup Cool Cleansing Oil. I love this stuff. I use this and then I use the, I'm blanking. Clinique Take the Day Off Balm or something, whatever it's called. And I do really love this one. It's so gentle, but it takes off your makeup beautifully as that first cleanse to really kind of break up your makeup and get it ready for your second cleanse. So I always repurchase this and I do love it. I have three CoverGirl, like their little micro brow pencils. They're just super cheap, super easy. And I'm not super picky about my brows, so this works for me. Next, I have a NYX Control Freak Eyebrow Gel. I did use this up because it's a great price point and it does like do the job. Sometimes I find when there's too much product on the brush, I can have little clumps in my eyebrows, so that wasn't really my favorite, so I'm kind of looking for a better one, but it did do the job. Oh boy, I just ordered a new pack of these, but this is the GlossierBomb.com. I love this chapstick. This is just the original scents, but like I said, I love the mint, I love the original. I just ordered a pack of three and added the coconut, so I'm so excited to try that. But yeah, this is always my favorite way to moisturize my lips. I keep one in my bathroom by my nightstand, and it just feels so great on my skin, and I can't get away from it. I absolutely love this stuff. So definitely repurchased again and again. This is the Green Tangerine Vita C Cream, and it's just a tiny little one. It was kind of like a little, I don't know if it was like a travel size. I just bought a pack of the vitamin C, and they gave me a little Vita C cream, little one. So I tried it out and I actually loved it. I still have to repurchase the vitamin C because I absolutely loved the one from this brand. So again, this is Green Tangerine. And I loved it. I have two essential oils to finish off the bag. These are Young Living Lavender and Peace and Calming. And I use these bad boys up. I think I went a little bit hard with diffusing and making roller balls when I first got like my little starter kit with them. I was going through a little bit of like sleep regression as like a 23-year-old, but I was not sleeping at night and just like panicking. And so I was just rubbing this every single second and putting it into the air and into anything that I could, and I love it. So yeah, these are just easy ones to have, but yeah, I love them. Okay, that is the first bag done. We're moving on swiftly. So in this bag, I have the Good Stuff Gentle Shampoo. This is sulfate-free shampoo. I got this at Target. and I absolutely hated it. It just like didn't do anything for me. I felt like every time I was in the shower, I couldn't get enough to like make my hair feel clean. You know, like when you can scrub it and it just feels like it's clean. It never felt clean. I also had the conditioner, but it was like a no rinse conditioner. So I really hated it and I definitely wouldn't recommend. This is the Raw Sugar Simply Body Wash in Vanilla Bean and Sugar. If there's a theme with any of my shower things, it's vanilla. I love the scent of vanilla, and especially in like a body wash or a scrub or something like that. And I love the Raw Sugar brand. It's a big bottle. I tend to go a little bit overboard with like things in the bottle. I'll just like squeeze it out. But this lasted me quite a while, and I did love it. It's at Target, easy to pick up. I think it's at all grocery stores, to be honest. This is the SGX NYC The Bodyguard, and this is a protective texture spray. I love this texture spray. I've talked about it before. I think I've had it, not in this bag, but I think I had it in my last empties video in June. And yeah, I love this brand. It's easy to get a hold of. It's like so cheap, and I feel like it works really well for my hair, and the texture spray is one of my favorite. I have a Dr. Teal's body lotion in coconut oil. This is so great. I love the Kiehl's, obviously the bubbles, the body lotion. It's just a great brand in my opinion, and it works really well with my skin. So yeah, anything coconutty, loved it. Used it all summer long. It was very great. I have a shampoo and conditioner by Kristen S, and I love her. I love her brand. It's so affordable and just great, great stuff. So I always pick it up again, and yeah, this is one of my favorite, just the signature one. I know that she has like a purple shampoo, and I think that's it. I don't know, she has lots of different things, but I do always love the signature one. It has a great smell, it makes my hair feel great, clean, and yeah. We have like an off-brand hairspray. I think Sebastian picked this up. This is like Equate Beauty. Again, I'm so not picky with my hairspray because I just don't really use it often, and yeah, you've heard my whole spiel. So we use that up. This is the Kiehl's Deep Cleansing Foaming Face Wash, and just like a tiny little one. I wanted to give it a try. I did love it. The foaming didn't irritate my skin or didn't dry anything out, but I just haven't gone back to pick up a like full-size bottle. I just haven't like been bothered to do so, but it did really work well, and I think if I see it again, I could pick it up, but I'm just using one right now that I really enjoy. I have a tiny little Tresemme travel hairspray. I believe I took this to Orlando with me, and I think that's why this is in here, but yeah, love it. I have a lot of hairspray. I have a Kristen S dry shampoo, and I love the dry shampoo. It's one of my favorites. I alternate between this one and the S, bitch, that always happens to me. I alternate between this one and the SGX, what's it called? This is not it, but the SGX NYC. I cannot do their branding. Yeah, I switch between those two and I really love them. This is the Hyaluronic Acid Intensive Care Cream by Cosrx, and it's completely empty because I absolutely love this brand. Again, this is the same brand as the PHA one, and both of these were stunning. I liked the hyaluronic acid because it just made my skin feel so hydrated and just like supple and cute, because I do love hyaluronic acid, and it was nice and easy for the summer, and then like a nice moisture cream is really good for the winter. So these two are definitely repurchases of mine. I love this brand. These are like all of my summer thing, so it's kind of making me sad, but this is the L'Oreal Sublime Bronze Self Tanner in Medium, and this is the coconut fragrance, and this was so good. My friend Mikkel told me to get this during the summer, and she was right. It works so well. I'm not like the best at self tanning, so I don't really like know what's amazing and what's not, but this didn't leave me any like weird orangey color. It made me smell so good because of the coconut, so that's why I really liked it. I still had like kind of streaks because I don't know how to put it on, but yeah, I really liked it. Oh, I have another one of the e.l.f. Flawless Finish Foundations. Already chatted about this, but yeah, I use it up twice. Again, great price point. Not the best foundation in the world, but also not too bad. I have a Maybelline Matte and Poreless Little Foundation. I don't love this. It's great, but like, it's not my favorite. I have two bottles of the Thayer Witch Hazel. This is lavender and this is cucumber. I loved the lavender. I hated the cucumber. Something about the cucumber in this like really irritated my skin and I didn't love it. But the original and the lavender are one of my favorites. I have another one of the Boschia Makeup Breakup Cleansing Oils. Again, you guys have heard my spiel. I love this. Always go back to it. This is something that I really was excited to try. This is the Differin Cleansing Daily Deep Cleanser, and I love Differin Gel. It's such an affordable, easy to get a hold of retinol at the store, and so I had to pick this up and try it. I didn't notice a huge difference. If you're gonna get something different, I would just get the Differin Gel, but it was still nice to try. I have the tiny little Mario Badescu facial spray in the chamomile and lavender, and I love this stuff. I have so many of these floating around my whole life because you can never have too many. I'm trying to speed up. I have two deodorants. This is the Love Beauty and Planet coconut water and mimosa flower, and I didn't like this at all. It's just like that natural deodorant that I just don't feel does it for me or works really well. So then I switched to the Dove Advanced Care, and this was fine. It just left a lot of white residue under my armpits, so that's why I then switched to the spray, which you guys know I love. Okay, we're back with a full battery. Hopefully I wanna wrap this up so I can clean up this mess. This last little bit is just kind of like makeup stuff I'm noticing, but this is a perfume. This is Tease by Victoria's Secret, and this scent makes me think of my sister so much. We used to be obsessed with this scent, and I feel like it's such a good one. Like, when I used to wear this when I was, like, not younger, but, like, when I first, like, got introduced to this, like, high school, middle school, I just would feel like a woman. Like, it is that, like, very, like, deep woodsy, not woodsy, but, like, a very deep scent. I'm not really good at explaining, but this just, like, smells like what you want a woman to smell like, so I just love it, and I really want to get this. Every time I smell it, I'm like, I need to pick that up, so that's always a good one. I have a tiny little Garnier Skin Active Soothing Facial Mist. I got these for my bachelorette party earlier this year, and I guess I didn't use it when I was there, so then I used it. I don't know. I literally don't know what I'm trying to say, but I like it. It's good. It's not one of my favorite mists. I would rather spend the money on, like, the Mario Badescu ones or just a little bit higher end, but it's good. Not too bad. I have a tiny little e.l.f. HD lifting concealer. I used this up just because I felt like it wasn't terrible, but I thought that this one was the camo concealer. I don't know why, but I thought that this one was what I needed, but it wasn't. So I didn't repurchase this because in the end I got the right one. This is the IT Cosmetics Bye Bye Foundation. I love this stuff. This is like my favorite stuff to wear during the summer. It's just a light, even coverage. It makes you feel very glowy, very dewy. So I definitely will repurchase in the summer because it is one of my favorites. And I have a e.l.f. camo concealer right here. I love this stuff. I always use it. I use it every single day. I talked about it in yesterday's video. I have my days mixed up. I talked about this, I don't know, my period essentials, because it is one of my favorites. And speaking of the Differin Gel, I have one right here. Again, it's such a good, easy retinol, especially that you can get at the grocery store, so I always tend to pick this back up. Right now, my skin is doing really well, and I think it is because of the vitamin C serum that I'm using, but when my skin needs a little bit of help, I love Differin Gel. I have two more essential oils. This is the Stress Away by Young Living. Again, when I had my little episodes, I was just like putting this everywhere that I could find, and it really did help. I really had like a moment of essential oil love for like a whole month. And I know that's not a long time, but I still like them. I still do my nighttime roller. I still have ones that I use when I feel like I need a little bit of a boost. Yeah, they're great. So this is Young Living, and then this is a For Life Calma Vita. It's just like their lavender blend, and I really love it. I love like anything stress away, make me sleep, lavender, chill me out. Those are my favorite oils. And then my last two products, this is the CoverGirl. Oh, I already talked about this, but this is a fourth one of the CoverGirl Eyebrow Pencil. I love it. It's so easy to get your hands on, and it just works well for my brows. And then this is the I Love Extreme Essence Volume Mascara. I love this stuff. My sister turned me on to this mascara, and it's one of my favorites. So cheap at Ulta. And they have a ton of good mascaras. So this is my new favorite. And that is everything. I hope that you guys enjoyed kind of seeing what I repurchased, what I wouldn't, all of my favorites. It's kind of like a big jumble of everything, which is why I really love these videos. Let me know your comments down below on any of these products that I talked about. I will leave some of my absolute favorites in the description box for you guys to check out, and I will see you guys in tomorrow's video. Bye!